Hi, I'm Walter Isaacson, author of The Codebreaker, the story of Jennifer Doudna, gene editing, and the future of the human race. It's a wonderful tale about a brilliant scientist and a really great person named Jennifer Doudna, but it's also the story about discovery, how discovery happened, and how people turn discovery into inventions. When she was in sixth grade, Jennifer came home one day and found on her bed a copy of a book called The Double Helix. She put it aside, thinking it was a detective story. And when she picked it up on a rainy Saturday afternoon a few weeks later, she realized, well, in a certain way, she was right. It was a tale about people trying to figure out the ultimate mysteries of life. It was filled with colorful characters and wonderful partnerships and rivalries, all in pursuit of the wonders of nature. It made Jennifer decide that she wanted to become a scientist. And even though her high school guidance counselor told her women don't become scientists, she decided she would, and she did. And she ended up being one of the discoverers of what James Watson, the author of that book, The Double Helix, later told her was the most important scientific discovery since his own co-discovery of the structure of DNA. She and her colleagues figured out something called CRISPR, which is a system bacteria have used for more than a billion years in their fight against viruses. What they do is when a virus attacks them, they can remember a little of the genetic code of that virus. So if the virus comes back, boom, they can chop it up and kill the virus. In other words, it's a system for immunity against viruses that's adaptive. It's just what we humans need in this era in which we've been plagued by wave after wave of virus pandemics. This technology, this tool, this gene editing tool has already been used to help fight the coronavirus. It's been used to cure genetic diseases such as sickle cell anemia. It's been used to fight cancer, and it's even been used now to design babies so that they can have particular genetic traits. In 2018, a Chinese scientist, in a somewhat of a rogue experiment, created the first designer babies. Two twins, two CRISPR babies that had their genes edited so they didn't have the receptor that would make them susceptible to the virus that causes AIDS. It was kind of premature. Scientists weren't ready for this to be used this way. And so arms flailed. There was shock and awe. Committees convened. Suddenly, after a billion years of evolution of life on this planet, one species, meaning ours, had the talent but also the temerity to edit its own genes, to hack its own evolution. It raised a whole lot of moral questions. If we could use this technology to edit our children and all of our descendants to be immune to viruses, would we do so? Well, after this coronavirus pandemic, I think a lot of us would say, well, maybe so. And what about using it to fight deadly inherited diseases like sickle cell or Huntington's or cystic fibrosis? Yeah, that sounds pretty good as well. And what about using it to cure deafness or blindness? Or keeping kids from being too short, or making sure they weren't depressed. How would we think about that? And what about doing things like giving our kids better athletic ability, or choosing their hair color, or making them blue-eyed, or taller, or adding to their IQ points if we could afford it? Wait. Before we fall all the way down this slippery slope, let's pause and think of the consequences. What will that do to the diversity of our species, of all the colorful diversity that makes life so rich and wonderful? And if these offerings at the genetic supermarket aren't free, and they won't be, what's that going to do to inequality? Is it going to encode the inequality we already have and encode it forever into our species? After helping invent this technology, Jennifer Doudna has taken the lead in wrestling with the moral questions and in dealing with the public policy debate. It's a wonderful story that we all have to figure out, because we, you and me, all of us, are going to have to figure out, what are we going to do with this powerful new technology? And it's also a wonderful story because it's about the mysteries of life. There's something beautiful, something joyful in being able to understand how something works, especially when that something is ourselves. That's what gave joy to Jennifer Doudna. That's what can give us all joy, and that's what this book is all about.